currently practice right now, unless you are a very high-earning surgeon, an ophthalmologist, a neurosurgeon, or an orthopod. What are docs to do? Well, some choose employment. And the main reason they choose employment, they just hire out to be somebody, some hospital doctor or sell their practice, less financial risk, fewer administrative responsibilities. But they don't really like the results because what they get, what they do like about employment, not having to deal with the business of running a practice, they like that. Not having to deal with insurers or billing. Guaranteed income. Most people would like a guaranteed income. Not here, but most people out in the real world would like one. But even if you sign your soul away, here's what they dislike about it. Limited influence in decision making. You're no longer captain of your ship, master of your soul. Somebody else is making the calls. More limited income potential, too many rules, less control over work schedule. So you just can't please them, right? Can't please them if they're employed, can't please them if they're working on their own because of the way it's stacked up. Here are ways for doctors to make more money. Teach students, provide care to prisoners, supervise physician assistants and advanced nurse practitioners, serve as an expert witness, examine patients for insurers, work for a drug company. I won't say any more on that. Work on a cruise ship. Or work at a nursing home. In fact, I want to show you this. This is the dropout club. Wes, I discovered this between the last time I was here and today. In fact, I was so impressed, I even registered for the dropout club so that I could get on their website. The dropout club is for doctors that want to drop out of medical practice and sell their souls to the pharmaceutical companies, etc. There did not used to be dropout clubs for doctors. This is like the rats fleeing the ship, the sinking ship. Okay, so I want to talk about karmic Jesus and Ziegler-approved ways for doctors to make more money. Let me define those. Karmic, what goes around comes around. Jesus said, do unto others as you would have them do unto you. And Zig Ziglar said you can have everything in life you want if you just help enough other people get what they want. So here's what I would suggest. Make them better. Take better care of your patient's needs. And the people here will know how to do this and how their doctors can help. Now, there is evidence that people are really frantically trying to get better out there. I love this one. Get your pneumonia shot today. By the way, they also carry liquor. And also, now this really, this actually makes my skin crawl. Low cost pet shots. So not only do they want to shoot you up with aluminum and mercury adjuvants, or aluminum adjuvants and mercury and thimerosal in your vaccines, but they want to do it to your pets as well. And then after they do it, I guess you could forget all your problems. And patients are going to the pharmacy and the grocery store looking for weight loss products. We just happen to have a program for that. So we can encourage our patients to eat better, more colorful fruits and vegetables, more plant-based protein, more real food, less fake food. People are actually taking supplements. And when we find out, when do supplement users start? In adulthood, 73% start as adults. And when we look at doctors, how many of them take supplements? The answer is over 50%. So if you are 46 and over, 50% of you over 50 are taking supplements. And both men and women, over 50%, docs are taking supplements. Do doctors typically recommend supplementation in their practice? Classically trained MD allopaths? No, they do not. They take their own supplements in secret and don't even bother to tell their patients about it. Conversely, who do patients and healthcare consumers trust? Their doctor. Do you all see an entrepreneurial potential here? If we can get scanners and education into healthcare practitioners' offices, and doctors can start talking to their patients about the value of supplementation and what it will do for them. And you will know after I tell you tomorrow about it. I think that we could do some real good. So some solutions. The scanner is amazing. It is now entirely portable. First time I saw the new one, I was blown away. First time I saw the first one, it took 45 minutes to an hour to get it going. We have a remarkable supplement, not a vitamin. John Whitaker has the fear of God in me for that. It is not a vitamin. It is a complete nutritional system, and I will deconstruct it for you tomorrow. And we have an absolutely amazing weight loss product that is a lot of people are on right now. The availability will return as of October, and then everybody can get it whenever they want. All right, so some of these are from Dr. Howard. I love this slide because he did it as an intern. So this is the typical patient flow in a general medical office. So this patient sets up the appointment, comes to the office, sees the nurse, sees the doc, nurse or assistant orders tests, and they check out. And so for all of that, it averages $38 net per visit when all expenses are pulled out and all the reimbursement nickel and diming is accounted for. You might bill $100 and you might get $38. So four visits, $152 a year, $152 per patient. What if instead the nurse or assistant scanned the patient? And just for instance, what if they started on nutritional supplementation like that one? Then this patient that is currently bringing $152 into the practice now brings $452 into the practice because there's a $300 net to the bottom line profit to the practice when the patient is on LifePak now over the course of the year. So that's some real benefit. This is a way for physicians to get themselves out of financial purgatory and do right by their patient. That's karma. Jesus would approve, Zig Ziglar would approve. It's time to put health back into healthcare and take back our profession. I close with this slide from Dr. Charlie, who said this years ago. For me, the practice of medicine has opened the door to the greatest adventure in life. Medicine is like a hallway lined with doors, each door opening into a different room, and each room opening into another hallway, again lined with doors. Medicine is always wonderful and never will be finished. Now that's medicine. It's not medical practice. It's not dealing with outrageously difficult insurance companies now, but it's the practice of medicine. It is the romance, the adventure of getting to know the patient, wrapping your mind around what's going on, coming up with a diagnosis, a treatment plan, and then collaboratively working with the patient to get him or her better. There's never been a better time to practice medicine. We've never had the great test that we do now. We've never had the genomic testing. We've never had LifePak Nano before, until relatively recently. We've never had TR90. It is a great time to practice medicine. And tomorrow, I'm looking forward to sharing with you more about the scanner and the supplements, per se. So thank you very much.